TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 4th of February. India's Interior Ministry says no decision on nationwide national register of citizens. Sri Lanka celebrates its 72nd Independence Day. And US demands demonstrable reduction in violence from Afghan Taliban. Now for all the details, India's Interior Ministry, in a written reply to a question in lower house of the parliament, said on Tuesday that the government has not taken any decision on bringing a nationwide national register of citizens yet. The NRC updation exercise in northeastern Assam province was aimed at filtering illegal immigrants.
India's Interior Ministry on Tuesday, in a written reply in lower house of the parliament Lok Sabha, said the government has not taken any decision on bringing a nationwide National Register of Citizens or NRC yet. Junior Interior Minister Nityanand Rai said in a written reply to the Lok Sabha that till now the government has not taken any decision to prepare National Register of Citizens at the national level. This is the first official response from the Interior Ministry over the question whether the centre is mulling to bring a nationwide NRC. The Citizenship Amendment Act and the proposed NRC has led to unabated protest across the country for the past 2 months. The NRC updation exercise was aimed at filtering illegal immigrants from northeastern Assam province. The final draft of the Assam NRC was published on July 31st last year.
Sri Lanka on Tuesday marked its 72nd Independence Day with a grand parade in capital Colombo. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa, in his address to the nation, pledged to guarantee every citizen the right to live free and safe within a unitary democratic state.
Sri Lanka on Tuesday celebrated its 72nd anniversary of gaining independence from the British colonial rule in 1948 with a grand parade in capital Colombo. The celebrations commenced at the Independence Square in Colombo after President Gotabaya Rajapaksa hoisted the national flag. The president, in his address to the nation, pledged to guarantee every citizen the right to live free and safe within a unitary democratic state. He called for a strong executive and legislature and an independent judiciary for a strong democracy.
Mage palana kalaya thuladida onema ayakuta tamanta kemathi agamak adahime nidahasa ma tahawuru karana bauddha darshanaya thula api rajya nayakayan palakayanta hama vitama upades labune neetiya
The majestic Independence Day parade featured the triforces and cultural performances by students and civil organizations. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa was elected on November 19 last year after promising to secure the country against militant threats. He had earlier served as defense chief under his brother Mahinda Rajapaksa, who himself served as president from 2005 to 2015.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan on Tuesday said his country will do its best to buy more palm oil from Malaysia after top buyer India put curbs on such imports last month amid a diplomatic row with the Southeast Asian nation.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan said on Tuesday that his country will do its best to buy more palm oil from Malaysia after top buyer India put curbs on such imports last month amid a diplomatic row with the Southeast Asian nation. Khan made the remarks while addressing a joint press conference after holding bilateral talks with his Malaysian counterpart Mahathir Mohamad in Putrajaya. Pakistan bought 1.1 million tons of palm oil from Malaysia last year, while India bought 4.4 million tons, according to the Malaysian Palm Oil Council.
We have had talks. These talks will be ongoing. The idea is to develop a much closer relationship, as I said, between of trading relationship, investment, doing joint things together, even in defense.
India last month put general restrictions on refined palm oil imports after Mahathir's criticism of abrogation of special status of Jammu and Kashmir and the move to make it easier for non-Muslims from Bangladesh, Pakistan and Afghanistan to gain Indian citizenship. India has maintained both the issues are its internal matters.
Moving on, education sector in Gilgit-Baltistan continues to be a cause of concern for locals. An atmosphere of despair prevails due to deteriorating higher education sector and lack of facilities that has adverse effect on the youth of the illegally occupied region who stand to benefit of a bright future.
Education is the central pillar for development of a society, and the importance of education is undeniable. However, education sector in Gilgit-Baltistan continues to be a cause of concern for the locals as the youth in the illegally occupied region lack the opportunity for higher studies and technical training. A social worker said universities in Gilgit-Baltistan lack modern facilities that the higher education institution requires. This has become a major challenge in the region, with authorities turning a blind eye towards the needs of the youth. Despite repeated pleas and demands, the administration of the region, which largely operates at the commands of Islamabad, has been apathetic to the crisis, according to locals.
बहुत सारे मसले मसाइले अब चूंकि एक सेक्यूलर इलाका है गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान दूरदराज के जो अजला है जो गांव है वहां पर लोगों को एक्सेस नहीं है उनके डोर स्टेप पे जो है एजुकेशन का फैसिलिटीज नहीं है और हुकूमती सतह पे तो हालांकि हुकूमत की जिम्मेदारी है ये सारी जो है डिमांड्स को पूरा करे या उसके मुताबिक उनको जो है इंतजामात करने चाहिए लेकिन गैर सरकारी सतह पे भी इस पे कोई खातिर ख्वाह काम नहीं हो सका है
इन रीसेंट डेज स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ काराकोरम इंटरनेशनल यूनिवर्सिटी हेल्ड प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट्स डिसीजन टू हाइक ट्यूशन फी दैट हैज एंटर्ड इट्स थर्ड मंथ. The university's position has only worsened the three-month-long impasse when no side is ready to budge.
U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said that the United States was moving ahead with Afghan peace talks with the Taliban to end the war in Afghanistan, but to reach a deal, the militant group must first give demonstrable evidence of their will and capacity to reduce violence in the country.
U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has demanded demonstrable evidence from the Taliban that it can and will reduce violence before signing any peace agreement that would lead to withdrawal of American troops from Afghanistan. Speaking at a news conference in Uzbekistan on Monday, Pompeo said, "A deal is close, but that they have been close before and failed because the Taliban was unable to demonstrate its seriousness." He further asserted more work remains to be done so that Afghan peace talks can get started.
We got close once before to having an agreement, a piece of paper that we mutually executed, and the Taliban were unable to demonstrate either their will or their capacity, or both, to deliver on a reduction in violence. And so what we are demanding now is demonstrable evidence of their will and capacity to reduce violence.
Pompeo's comments came just a day after U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad concluded his trip to Kabul and briefed Afghan leaders including President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah about United States' efforts to reach an understanding with the Taliban. Ghani has been unable to agree on a negotiating team with Abdullah as the chief executive accuses him of foiling efforts by imposing ceasefire as a precondition for talks. Taliban has so far expressed willingness for a reduction in violence, but not ceasefire.
The government of Nepal has said it is working to evacuate its citizens from China, the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak that has reported over 400 deaths. The government also informed the process for evacuation from China would require additional 3 to 4 days.
The government of Nepal said on Monday it is working to evacuate its citizens from China, the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak that has reported over 400 deaths. Addressing a press briefing on Monday evening, Nepal's health ministry spokesperson Mahendra Shrestha informed that process for evacuation from China would require additional 3 to 4 days. As many as 180 Nepalese, including 3 children, have approached the country's embassy in Beijing, demanding their evacuation from the country.
त्यसकारण त्यहाँको पाँचवटा मेजर शहरबाट मान्छेहरू आउँदैछन् त्यसले गर्दाखेरि उनीहरूलाई कलेक्सन गर्ने उनीहरूलाई कहाँ के गर्ने भन्ने विषयमा अझै 3-4 दिन लाग्छ त्यहाँ है त्यहीँको पनि लाग्छ.
Meanwhile, Nepal is yet to finalize on places where those evacuated from China would be kept for a quarantine period of at least 2 weeks. A Nepalese student who had come home on holiday from Wuhan in China was tested positive for the coronavirus last month, making it the first confirmed case in South Asia. More than 10 people are currently suspected to have been infected with the virus in the Himalayan nation.
A fresh batch of Hindu pilgrims who came to India from Pakistan on Monday said they do not want to return even after their visa expires. This comes at a time when widespread protest against India's new citizenship law continues to rage across the country.
A fresh batch of Hindu pilgrims arrived in India from Pakistan on Monday via the Wagha Atari border to visit the holy city of Haridwar in India's northern Uttarakhand province. Many of these travellers who have arrived on a 25-day tourist visa said they do not want to return to Pakistan even after their visa expires and wish to settle in India. The pilgrims that came with their families and a lot of belongings also slammed Pakistan for its treatment of minorities.
Pakistan to acha hai wo bhi ek din Hindustan tha magar wo abhi musalmanon ka desh ho gaya ye Hindustan hai to yahan par Hindu ka rehna sahi hai बस यही सोच कर आए हैं यहाँ पर
25 डेज की मेरी वीजा है हरिद्वार में स्नान करके फिर मैं सोचूंगा कि कहाँ रहना है कहाँ नहीं रहना
तो आपका मन है हिंदुस्तान रहने का
बिल्कुल
The visit comes at a time when widespread protest against India's new citizenship law, the Citizenship Amendment Act, continue to rage across the country. Citizenship Amendment Act provides provision for fast-tracking citizenship to persecuted religious minorities from India, Pakistan and Bangladesh who took a refuge in India before 2015. Critics, however, say the law based on religion is against the secular fabric of the country.
Scores of monks and devotees on Monday participated in an annual religious procession in India's Buddhist pilgrimage town of Bodh Gaya. The vibrant procession was taken out with colourful dancers in order to showcase the ashes of Lord Buddha, the founder of Buddhism, and two of his chief disciples.
Scores of devotees, monks and children participated in an annual vibrant religious procession in Buddhist pilgrimage town of Bodh Gaya, in India's eastern Bihar province on Monday. The procession was taken out with colourful dances in order to showcase the ashes of Lord Gautam Buddha, the founder of Buddhism, and his two chief disciples, Arihant and Sariputta, to the devotees. Apart from the local devotees, people from various countries including Sri Lanka, Thailand, Japan, South Korea and Tibet also participated in the three-day event.
These 3 days, we organize public holy relics exposition. So many devotees from various countries coming to have a glimpse and pay respect and pay homage to these holy relics of Buddha and his two chief disciples.
For Buddhists, Bodh Gaya is one of the most important pilgrimage sites related to the life of Gautam Buddha, as it is the place where Lord Buddha is said to have attained supreme knowledge. Showcasing the Buddhist holy relics is an annual event in Bodh Gaya, which is being carried out regularly since 2007.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.